Hi guys, and welcome back to another cleaning video. My name's Katie Satilli. If you're new here, I post videos every Wednesday and Sunday, so if you aren't subscribed, make sure you hit that red subscribe button and hit the bell notification so that you can be reminded anytime I upload new content. Today's video is gonna be one that is created for adults, and it is all about taking down Christmas and kind of organizing and decluttering the house as I go and getting things re-put back together for the year 2020. I would love to hear down in the comments what some of your New Year's resolutions are for the year 2020. I know for me, I have a ton and I don't even have them like perfectly all organized yet, but I will be sharing them throughout this video. So don't click out if you want to hear some of my New Year's resolutions. One of my New Year's resolutions is to be more real on social media. I don't know exactly how I'm gonna do this, but this is something that I like to do in general, but I also want to grow in, and I think I'm known for being pretty real on social media and in life in general, but I want to kind of push myself to have more posts and more vlogs that are more raw and real and genuine and authentic to who I am. So that is one of my goals for the year. Another one of my goals for the year is to work on my health and get a little bit more physically fit. I want to lose a few pounds, not a ton, but I would like to lose a few and kind of get more toned. And so how I'm going to be doing that is I'm going to be buying a gym pass, which I know I had asked you guys in an earlier vlog what you guys thought about me getting a gym pass and if you recommend it. And I got lots of different feedback. Some saying yes, some saying no, and I think I just decided that I have to do something a little bit different than what I've been doing, because I usually do at-home workouts, which I have loved in the past, but I'm kind of bored with it, so I'm going to try to do something new and just kind of switch it up, and maybe I'll be able to do a mix of at-home workouts and also in-gym workouts. So anyways, that's my plan for the year, and I'm excited about it. Thank you. so funny because as I was taking down the ribbons from the Christmas tree, I was reminded of the Christmas video that I did with my friend Anna where we put this tree together and how much fun that was. And it's so funny because it turned out really cute, but over time it kind of started drooping and sagging and my kids kind of got the best of it, at least the bottom half of the tree. So I don't know, maybe next year I will do something a little bit different. I was thinking of doing like a kid's tree next year, which is not necessarily my favorite type of tree to do, but I feel like the kids need a year to where they can just put every single ornament that we own up on the tree and I can just suck it up and not have to have it be all perfect. So anyways, what do you guys think about that? I'd love to hear down in the comments. Do you think that I should do a kids themed tree for next year, meaning just mass chaos on the tree? Or should I do another themed Christmas with like something that was more like Buffalo Check or rustic or who knows what else I could think of for next year? If you're new here, this is Fiona. She's 6 years old and she is my daughter, who is my oldest. And she likes to help decorate and clean, and I think she got it from her mom. So it's so fun when she wants to help out. I especially like it when I don't even have to ask, which is what had happened this day. She cleaned the window for me with Windex and then she was just in the cleaning mood. So she went in and cleaned the bathroom. This is not something that happens all the time, by the way. It's not like I have something figured out with how to make my kids want to clean, but she does it sometimes and I love when she does it. Just because I think it's a good habit for her to learn and grow in, and then also it helps me out around the house. So she had gone around and collected all of the soaps and candles for me from the bathroom and the kitchen because those were all Christmas type soaps and candles, and so she was trying to find the New Year's soaps and candles, which I don't really have any. But anyways, so I'm excited to pull out some new soaps and candles for the year and just get things a little bit more plain and simple. So this year I decided to put away my Christmas pajamas with the Christmas decor because I'm not gonna wear this stuff during the year really, which last year, I'm not gonna lie, I did wear some of my Christmas pajamas during the year. So I wanted to kind of put them away, but it was perfect because I just wrapped up some of the breakable items inside the Christmas pajamas and shirts and all that stuff. So it kind of worked out perfectly. And I kind of just killed two birds with one stone. The This was me realizing that I was not strong enough to cut through zip ties, which who knew they were so strong, which I guess that's why they work so well. But I was calling my husband over because I could not figure out how to cut through that zip tie. So anyways, he's gonna do the rest for me, which I was super thankful for. So I decided to grab some trash bags and start putting away certain things that didn't fit into my bins. So I wish that I had more space in my garage, and I don't know, it's like the never-ending comment of I wish I had more space, but oh well, I don't have more space, so I'm gonna do the best I can with what I have. So anyways, I just bagged up some of that garland, and then I'm going to bag up the other stuff so that it doesn't get dusty throughout the year. And yeah, let me know in the comments if you have any tips on putting away Christmas decor or how you put away like some of these bigger items, because if I put a lantern inside a bin, it's gonna take up like one bin per lantern, which is just not gonna happen. So anyways, I'd love to hear any tips that you have down in the comments. So I'm starting to run out of a lot of the Grove products that I had from back when I used to work with Grove. And so now I'm kind of wondering like what some of your favorite cleaning products are. So I'd love to hear that down in the comments, if you would be so kind to share with me what some of your favorite sprays are right now, whether it's from Target or from Grove or wherever you buy your cleaning stuff from. I'm in the market for purchasing some new sprays for my countertops, and I love having good smelling sprays, so let me know down in the comments what some of your favorites are. Thank you. I just loved sharing with you my New Year's resolutions for the year. I have more, but I just figured that I would give a few to you, and I'd love to hear some of yours back in the comments. And thanks for watching another video with me. It is so much fun doing these videos, and I feel like I have a new passion and excitement for the year 2020 for my YouTube channel. So don't forget to hit that red subscribe button, hit the bell so that you can get notified anytime I upload new content, and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. And I will see you in my next video. Hope you have a wonderful day. Bye guys!